him one time and said, how can you stand to put your hands in holes underwater where you can't see? This is muddy water, you know. He said, well, you know, you just feel your way around and you can feel what's in there. If it's a catfish, it feels smooth. If it's a big carp, you know, it feels scaly. And if it's a turtle, you can feel it's a turtle. And I said, well, what if it's a snake? He said, well, you go to the next hole.
The first time I touched the fish under the water, when I touched it, I thought I was touching something, you know. I just jumped. I jerked my hands out like that. And after that, you know, and I tried again. And it was a fish, you know. I kind of feel it easy in both sides, you know, and come with my hand, you know, and I'll call it and bring it out like that.
Did you fish here? I got a little one. Got it dead off in front.
What is special is that at the end of the 20th century, that there still could be people in this country that can go out to the bayou and drag fish with their bare hands out of the bayou. That is rare. That is not common. It's an example of a close integration with environment that is no longer common in this country.
We're gonna go from this side.
Yeah.
That low?
Oh, that stump. That's good on either one or
that washout.
Yeah. You can be on the either side or the low, which side you want.
I'll get this side because it's a deeper side. And this stuff must have filled
in. With regard to hand fishing and seining on the prairies, we're looking at the development of a new type of technology. Acadians did not employ hand fishing. In the streams in Nova Scotia, predispersal Nova Scotia. What they attempted to do was simply to erect a line of weirs along the coast in the shallows during the during high tide periods, and then simply recover the fish that were trapped by the weirs as the tides receded. The type of technology, the hand fishing and the seining, that you see developed later in the prairie area here in Louisiana. This is a new technology. It's one that appears at a period when the type of technology that the Acadians previously exercised in Nova Scotia was long since forgotten. So you're looking at a new technology, hand fishing being something indigenous to Louisiana and something probably borrowed from the local Indians.
He touched you?
Hand fishing. From the old people, because I don't know where they learned it. They started from way back somehow, you know, way on the back. And, you know, like this year, we feel it under the logs, under the root, under the hollow trees, or like on the bayou, that's where they stayed in there. That's where the catfish like to go in that hole.
He's at you over there.
Mm-hmm.
I got it.
Well, hand fishing is an interesting adaptation, and to a cultural ecologist, it's very interesting that today there are people in southwest Louisiana that can dive into a bayou and pull out a live fish. But hand fishing is more than that. Hand fishing was a setting for a lot of socialization to take place. The same people that went to the bayou were the ones that actually hand fished. There were some that cooked. There were some that told stories. There were some that, played music. It was a social event.
On my mother's side and on my father's side, they all go hand fishing. Sometimes we were maybe 10, 15 men in the water catching fish with all the family, maybe 35, 40 people there on the bank of the bayou. It was a big thing.
Some of the, best stories that I've ever heard from my family were their days of hand fishing, because there was so much joy that they didn't have to work. They didn't have to get up and do their chores. They didn't have those responsibilities. All they had to worry about was getting those fish out of the bayou and cooking them.
We'd meet other people as well, sometimes other group that was out there fishing. It was fun.
If it was a house dance or a boucherie or whatever, and hand fishing was one of these things where people would get together. They'd get together sometimes two or three families, maybe extended family or neighbors or some such. And they would go out into the wild and catch a few fish, and they'd haul their pots and their pans and eating equipment out there, and the ladies would have a chance to talk, the children would have a chance to play together, and the men would have a chance to do something together. You know, people didn't have a whole lot of money, and so they did what they did together, and they had to depend on each other. And I think that those kinds of communal gatherings were very important in weaving together the fabric of our society.
Could drink the water of just about any bayou. It clear, and it wasn't muddy like it is nowadays. The farmers wouldn't know water level, so the water stayed clear. The bayous were clear.
That's what we'd use. Like to cook rice, we'd use bayou water too. But in the early years, but when it got in the later years, that water wasn't fit for that. No more. You know, it was more muddy, and a lot of times you got a little salt water in there, and a lot of times some oil. And you'd hit some places like in a curve where the bayou would turn, they'd have some oil in it. Then the fish in there wasn't good either. It would taste. When that fish started to cook, in case you hadn't noticed it before, when you'd raise that curve, it smelled like cool oil.
The clean farming practices begun in the 1960s on the prairies of southwest Louisiana, and the subsequent dredging practices which had to be employed in order to keep all this topsoil that was moving into the bayous because of erosion, because of clean farming. These dredging practices ruined not only the water quality of the bayou, but also the quality of the backwater areas, which wood ducks depend on, and which many animals depend on, not directly, but indirectly, because of the particular plant species that grow in these backwater areas. When you dredge a river or a bayou and you lose your backwater areas, you're losing a large, large chunk of your ecosystem in plant material.
One of the problems is they have to find bayous that haven't been ruined for the sake of drainage. You know, the only way you can get elected a parish official is to say, I'm for better roads and drainage. Because, of course, in South Louisiana, you know, there's high water just about everywhere. We're only a few feet above sea level everywhere. And so if you promise drainage and you promise to keep people's yards dry, then people listen to you. But on the other hand, in trying to do that, in dredging these bayous, we've just about ruined the natural ecology and natural habitat for a lot of our fish.
There are no more hollow logs, much less clean water. So there's no place for the catfish to breed. So we're not going to have catfish that we can hand fish for anymore, except in very isolated spots.
It was also a way of extracting food from the environment that didn't damage the environment at all. All you were doing was walking through the water and cleaning the holes. I think that the old-time Cajuns were very respectful of their environment. It was all they had, after all, and they had to depend on it for survival. And when you're in that kind of situation, you very quickly learn that you can't abuse the environment. And I think that for all those reasons, it's more than a quaint custom. It's characteristic of the way we are and why we are the way we are.
Sometimes water was a little bit cold, but we'd go in anyway. Make a fire on the bank, and when it got too cold, get back out and warm up a little bit and go back in until we had enough to eat.
The fact that hand fishing is no longer common in southwest Louisiana is indicative of an erosion not only of bayou resources, but of the traditions that enable men to use these resources. In some cases, the erosion and loss of the traditional knowledge may be even more profound than the environmental erosion. So we know that there are no books written on how to hand fish in southwest Louisiana. Once the link with tradition is lost, once people are no longer learning by imitation how to hand fish, then that knowledge can be irretrievably lost.
You know, when I was coming up, actually when my children was coming up, it was an embarrassment if you couldn't talk in English. And I think it was an embarrassment if you tell people you would go out there and hand fish. And I think it's something we got away from and we regret it.
People are hand fishing on purpose the same way that people are speaking to their children in French on purpose, the same way that people are buying accordions for their children on purpose. We are unfortunately in a position now where in order to preserve important parts of our culture, we have to do it on purpose. But if that's the case, then so be it.
If you knew how to fish turtles, you wouldn't just point your fingers down there. You'd go down with your hand flat, go straight down. When you reached, you touched one, you could tell by the prongs on the back which end was the business end. And the head end, of course, is smooth, round. And then we'd always reach right above the head where he couldn't get to it with one hand and follow the prongs back to the tail end where the shell is serrated. And we'd grab him right above the tail in the back. So we had him where he couldn't turn one way or another. But if you stick your hand in his mouth, that'd have been all she wrote.
Well, go ahead, son. Comes the graver now, bro.
We wouldn't think about trying in sacks to the bayou, you know, because moss was so plentiful. You just get on the bank, the first tree you come to would have some moss, so you did get a big handful of moss and go stop up your hole with it. Nowadays, it's hard to find some. I usually tie a rope around my waist. And nowadays, simply because you you carry some sacks around with you, and that's the best way to carry them in the water. You dub them over that rope that you have around your waist. Now that rope can come in very handy, which sometimes that you can corner you a big one. And the best thing to do with a big one, if it's possible, especially if there's two men, is put a rope in his gill, and then you know you won't lose your fish. Because you take a big catfish, if he gives you a good jerk, it's hard to hold on to.
Now we need those sacks. We need those two, and one more for sure. In fact, we need all of them. Come on, come from my back, and just go ahead and block up the front, Danny. But don't push them in. Okay. Got it? Go try to find a cold block. They got one in there, and I tell you what, don't move. I got another hole. Felt his tail. I'm gonna get what you have. You must have bumped it.
Oh, I bumped it, all right. That came to you?
Oh, man, that thing showed that stuff.
You got a sack in your hand?
Yeah.
Did you? Did you have a sack in your hand?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I won't need it.
Yeah.
If I'm not, you'll have to need it. We'll have to go back down together. Try to keep it blocked with your feet and everything else. You still blocked up there?
Oh, yeah. He can't come out from this way. No way.
Okay. You might have to back me up. Okay. I'll tell you what, if I can pull him to the end of the hole, you want to pull that rope off, you're going to tie him. All right. It's a nice one. It's a big one. I don't want to lose him.
Well, let's not lose him.
Okay?
All right.
Okay, let me go down and see if I can grab him.
Got him, huh?
Yeah, I got him.
Okay. Wait, I'll put the rope on him.
Pull that rope. Yeah, pull that rope. Oh, it won't. Okay, that's good. That's good. Go ahead. Hold on to him, man.
Oh, yeah.
Almost lost him right there.
Okay, I got it.
Okay.
Just
okay.
Hold on to the rope.
Make sure, do one more knot, just an extra knot, just to make sure.
All right.
Come on, baby.
Oh, go ahead, that's a nice one. Nice.
Watch him, he'll cut you up right there.
Yeah.
I don't want to drop fall with him. All right.
Oh, yeah. All right.
That's just about feed the crowd.
I think so.
What you think?
Oh, yeah.
Maybe another smaller one?
Well, might be another one in the dump.
Thank you. pas pour les hommes.
Mais toi, mais toi, mais
avec les batteurs, je pense que c'était plus sérieux parce que les chambres, ça a fait trop là.
Merci.
Rien qu'une chose qui est meilleure que ça. C'est plus. C'est plus. Plus, ouais.
This is a heritage which was given to us and really could not be taken away. One of the things that can't be taken away from anybody, no matter how poor they are, they have that bayou and everything that's in it until somebody ruins that for them.
The difficulties that we have now in being able to fish by hand are symptomatic of the larger issue. It's related to the coastal erosion. It's related to everything else that's happening to our environment. We've ruined large parts of it trying to improve our life.
If they keep, the what programs they have now to try to improve the water quality of the bayous, I really think that it might get back like it was years ago.
The American Indian and the Cajun did so well in South Louisiana just on surviving on the things that were right around them in their immediate vicinity. They didn't never ask for more, and I don't think they really wanted anything more.
Blue catfish and yellow catfish and spotted catfish in there too.
Which one is your favorite to eat?
I like anything without catch.